Dedicated to my brother Anton. A common grass snake crawled into mountains and lay there curled in a gorge so humid, high, steep, and narrow. The sun was shining high in the heavens. The cliffs breathed sultry up to the heavens. Sea waves were dashing against the outcrops. Wildly and loudly, a stream was rushing down gorge's bottom to meet the ocean, raving and raging. All in white billows, hoary but forceful, it cut the mountain and fell it seawards, angrily wailing. All of a sudden, into that canyon where lay the grass snake, a falcon landed, almost there falling. Blood on his feathers, his breast all broken, he cawed and struggled. In futile anger, the rocks dislodging. Disturbed and frightened, withdrew the grass snake, but soon he gathered that the poor falcon his last was breathing. Up to him creeping, so hissed the grass snake to the maimed falcon. What, are you dying? Yes, I am dying, answered the falcon, deeply now sighing. I lived in glory. I fought so bravely. Happiest was I. I've seen the heavens. You'll never see them so near or clearly, you wretched fellow. The sky is but a vast, empty nothing. How will I crawl there? I'm fine with this place, so warm and humid. So spoke the grass snake to the free falcon and laughed inside him at the poor falcon for his chimera. And thought he also, fly you or crawl you, the end is common. All ceases living. All turns to ashes. But the brave falcon suddenly sat up, shook the death off him, if only briefly. The water trickled through moldy cliff face. The gorge felt stuffy, dark, damp, and sullen. And cried the falcon with pain and chagrin, his last strength pouring into that outcry. Oh, for a one just last glimpse of freedom, I'd hold my rival to wounds mine closely. To death he'd choke in my bloody torrents, the lust of battle. And thought the grass snake, it must be pleasant, the skies to live in. Just hear him moaning. And he suggested to the free falcon, why don't you move to the edge of chasm? Cast yourself downwards, and who knows, maybe your wings would catch a rising current, and you would live then, if only briefly, in your home spaces. The falcon shuddered, cawing then proudly, he limped forth slowly towards the chasm, his talons slipping on slimy surface. The edge now reaching, his wings wide spreading, he sighed so deeply, his eyes all blazing, and threw him downwards. Oh, did he plummet, hopelessly stone-like, losing his feathers, his wings are breaking. The stream him gathered, off his blood washing, in white foam covered, last rites bestowing, and seawards took him. The restless ocean was roaring madly, and cliffs attacking. The falcon's body was lost forever in wide sea spaces.